24-5, public holiday. Okay, this terrapin comes in, 4 years old, male. You can see by the nails, it's quite long. Normally males don't have longer nails. Now 4 years old, the length is a bit short because of the probably the lack of space to run around. As you can see, he was on this tank. This tank is a very small tank for this terrapin to swim or to exercise. So now why he comes in, what's the reason? Not eating, right?
Yeah.
For 2 months. It was adopted 1 year ago. And you can tell that the terrapin is not eating from the shit, from the stools. So the water is very clear. That means he hasn't got any appetite. Because when you put the pellets in, it's all dissolved, so you can't tell whether it's eating. But a healthy terrapin will eat the pellets directly. So normally this terrapin should eat about 20 to 30 pellets a day, the terrapin pellets. And how many did he eat at the beginning? When you adopted him last year?
Oh, he did not eat any pellets.
At the beginning, when you adopted him, he didn't eat any pellets?
Yeah, I just gave him the
shrimps.
Yeah.
The dried one, right?
Yeah.
So he just added no pellets?
Yeah.
Huh?
Until he stopped eating, then I put 3 pellets
in. Okay, so in this case, this terrapin may not have a balanced diet because it's just eating the dried shrimps, right?
Mm.
70%.
Because normally the pellets will have some vitamins and minerals put in, especially from good companies. They do formulate the vitamin A, which if there's deficiency, then you can see swollen eyes. Now you can see the deficiency of vitamin A will be over a period of time, the eyelid will be swollen, and the terrapin is lethargic. So that'd be one reason. Now the other reason is there's a respiratory distress. You can see from the neck here, you can see further down, you can see it having a rapid breathing. You can see the movement?
Yeah.
Okay. I'll zoom in. So this one has been going on for how long? 2 months ago, right?
Yeah.
So it's most likely he has this infection, because you can see that he's been submerged in the water for the past 1 year, right? And water only change about three times a week. But then things that he has no area for him to climb up and dry himself, so it's always wet. And that is a very important thing for this semi-aquatic. So the thing is, so submerged in water, and then there's no possibility of drying up and having the direct sunlight, although the terrapin had some sunlight under the in the tank, right, for 4 hours. Only recently?
Yes.
Also recently, but before that, nothing. So that is the thing that now we look at the side. He has lost a lot of weight because you can see, it's like a human being. You can see the no flesh, no fat. There's no fat here. Normally it's quite fleshy. You can hear there's no more fat. You see the whole abdominal area. But you can see from here, it's all shrunken. So now the thing is to put the terrapin onto dry areas. And the prawns, I don't think it's the cause of it. You fed fresh prawns for two times only in the last how many months?
Like,
and he likes it, but only two times.
May, then you start.
Yeah, so May to September only 2 times only, so the owner may be worried about parasites. But the most likely problem is due to bacterial infection of the lungs. The lungs and the chest. According to the owner, this rapid breathing already started 2 months ago, right? So the only good news is that he hasn't got this open mouth, gasping for breath. That would be quite late. That means he's already seriously infected. So now the treatment should be antibiotics, sunlight, vitamins, and eye drops. Okay.